Hey y'all, Little Drummer Boy here, and today we lost a great in the music industry. We lost Kenny Rogers, who made it big in country rock group First Edition in the late 60s, and then in the 70s became a superstar with songs like The Gambler, which you hear behind me on the turntable, and songs like Reuben James, Lady, Lovers in the Stream, his duet with Dolly Parton. Kenny had a great voice. A lot of people also don't know that he was instrumental in putting the Eagles on the map. Back when he was in First Edition, the Eagles are Linda Ronstadt's band. And I think Kenny heard them somewhere and got them a record deal. So Kenny was instrumental in putting the Eagles on the map, and will be forever grateful for him to him for that, as well as all the great songs, Kenny Rogers songs he gave us. I saw him in 1989 at the Charlotte Coliseum on Tavola Road, the 1988 Charlotte Coliseum, with the Oak Ridge Boys and Patti Loveless and a Christian comedian named Andy Andrews, who opened up for them. Well, actually, Andy Andrews, Patti Loveless, and it was kind of like a double headline tour with Oaks and Kenny. And then Patti Loveless. I saw Lori Morgan with Alabama and Clint Black. Gosh, I can't talk tonight. Been a long day, y'all. Promise I'm not drinking, though. I'm sober. But anyway, I saw Lori Morgan with Clint Black in Alabama. But I saw Patti Loveless with the Oak Ridge Boys and Kenny Rogers. And I had real good seats for that one. And they came around, and I went down front and got to slap hands with Kenny Rogers and Dwayne Allen from the Oak Ridge Boys. So, and y'all just, if you're younger, like a millennial or the Generation Z or whatever it is that comes after millennials, you don't understand how big this dude was. In 1978, when I was in third grade, this song was huge. I mean, this song, The Gambler, was just huge in 1978. Everybody was singing it. You gotta know when to hold them and to fold them. It was a big deal, and it was a crossover. Kenny was crossover. His songs charted top 40 country and in top 40 pop music. You know, he was a great crossover artist. I mean, like songs like Lady were number one on both charts. You know, I mean, he had a bunch of great songs that, and like Alabama and a lot of other country artists of the day, he was crossover. Country singers don't have that appeal quite as much nowadays. One thing, country's lost its identity anyway, you know, I mean, I always liked country rock. I thought that was cool. And rock is a combination of blues and country anyway, from the get-go. That's what Elvis did. He combined the two. Bill Haley, same thing. But yeah, nowadays, country, country has turned pop. I mean, it's not even crossover anymore. It's not even, most of it isn't even country anymore. It's just, it's pop, you know? It's pop and soft rock. But that's kind of, let's face it, music in general has lost its way because there's no soft rock anymore. There's hardly any metal. There's hardly any lead guitar music anymore, any keyboards. There's no harmony singing anymore. There's nobody singing parts anymore like the Beach Boys did and the Eagles. And they're impeccable harmonies. But anyway, I didn't mean to get off on a tangent about modern music and what I think of most modern music. Some of it's great, but I don't know. Since the 90s, music seemed to have lost the artistry of music. But this is Lady. Yeah, this is a huge ballad for Kenny. And but anyway, yeah. Those of you who are like Gen X, like me, or baby boomers before us, and the greatest generation, those of you that are left from the greatest generation, we're sad today. We're sad to hear about the loss of Kenny Rogers. He was 81 years old, and he had a great voice and great songs, and he'll be missed. He'll be missed in the music world, especially for those of us old enough to remember great music, or for those of you whose parents did their job and introduced you to great music and made you listen to it, whether you liked it or not, because at least you know it. I used to love that one about, "You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille." And I used to like to sing, instead of "Four Hungry Children," I would sing, I was about eight then too, I would sing, "With 400 children and a crop in the field." But yeah, God bless Kennedy. Kenny, I talk about politics too much on my channel, y'all. I keep wanting to say Kennedy. God bless Kenny Rogers' family, his friends, his bands, and millions of us fans. Little Drummer Boy, if you like my content, please subscribe, hit the like button, and hit the bell icon if you subscribe so you can be notified when I have uploads in the future. Thank you, and have a blessed night. R.I.P. Kenny Rogers.